It's time to get on the right path with Right Path Real Estate Radio with Tom Perry.
Hey, welcome, Facebook folks.
Get the answer to your question that's keeping Morning. You from taking How's action and succeeding today. Get ready. The guy that will put your fears behind you is on the air now.
Mike's on.
Call at 713-785-1817. Toll free 877-881-0271. Now here's your host, Tom Perry.
Hey, welcome to the show. Welcome to the show, Right Path Real Estate Radio. We've got a call-in number, 713-785-1817. My name's Tom Perry, the host of the show. Joined live in the studio, my brother from another mother, my good friend, my co-host, Mr. Daniel G.
Good morning.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Always glad to be here.
So I'm getting Facebook up and going on my computer. Man, it's been an interesting morning already. So lots of things going on.
Yeah.
Yep. And it was a late. My last meeting ended 10:30 last night.
Okay.
Something like that. Real estate, man. I tell you what, we're working on some really large projects.
We are.
I would say that we probably have seven. Really large projects between what's going on in Houston House Buyers, Right Path, Quality Property Solutions. When I look at, and then also ABC.
Yeah.
So the Asset Buyers Club. So when I look at where my time's being spent, it's like, man, oh man, oh man, it's we're blowing it going.
We are,
and it's exciting.
Sure,
I mean,
it is.
Just because you know, it's one thing when you're putting together a business and you're just starting out. There's a lot to do, a lot of things you don't know, things like that. It's another thing to totally redesign and improve
Yes.
existing businesses. 'Cause, and the way I describe that is imagine you're going down like you're a train mechanic. And you know, like a railroad train, right? And those you've seen those big wheels, right?
Yeah.
Imagine the trains, you know, clickety-clack down the railroad tracks. And your job is, while the train is going down the track 40, 45 miles an hour, that you need to grease the wheels.
Oh, fun.
And not lose a limb.
Not
lose an arm or a leg or something like that. And sometimes it kind of feels like that because you still have to continue doing the business.
Yes.
Because that doesn't stop. Doesn't like you don't hit a pause button.
You
like
don't.
I'm listening to an audiobook right now. The how not to, you know it's like I'm reading it when I can, and then I'm listening to the audio version
yeah.
just to keep. I mean, coming in this morning, that's what I was doing. I had said I was going to call somebody at 8:45 this morning, and I did, and then they didn't answer, so I texted real quick, and then I got another phone call coming in at the same time, and I said, hey, I'll call you right back at 10 right after the show, and. You know, it should be a relatively quick call, but you know our schedule this morning.
Yep.
I mean, we got a 10 o'clock, and then we got an 11:15, and then I've got a 1 o'clock
lunch appointment.
Yeah,
and then right back at it after lunch.
Right. So it's been full days.
It has been full days,
which has been exciting, and I know we got in the second segment we've got Jet Lending Johnny Hayes, and
yes.
I think he's in Omaha for the
World Series.
World Series,
the college, is it college?
Yeah, absolutely.
World Series
not
of baseball,
not the pros.
Yeah. Not well, I knew that, but
not,
you know,
not,
there's little league, there's college,
no,
there's
right.
all different.
Yeah.
Hey, good morning, Mr. Perry.
Yeah,
yeah, there's all different levels of that. He was actually saw a thing on Facebook. I guess he has a break where he's going to be coming back.
Right.
So he was like, "Hey, anybody want to stay in my room for these 4 days?"
Right. Or I saw that too. Yeah. I don't see. I've spent maybe. You know, for a while I was spending maybe 30 minutes on Facebook a day just reading posts, things like that. And what I realized is that at the end of 30 minutes, I'm like, have I learned anything new? No. Have I gotten any insight on something? No. I mean, is it – so it's like then I realized what?
So for me on like I've got, I don't know, 3,600 people because, you know, when you're doing things like we do and
right.
you're in the public eye, you get a lot of requests and things
sure.
like that.
Right.
But Facebook allows you to follow or not follow the people.
Right.
So I may have 3,600 people on my friends list, but my feed is limited to a very few number of people.
Right. Right.
So I can usually scroll through my feed and see the 30 people that I want to keep up with in about 10 minutes. And
yeah.
I might do that twice a day.
Yeah.
So I did see that this morning, and I actually Googled what's going on in Omaha
oh, yeah.
because I didn't know.
Right, yeah.
I was like, why is he in Omaha, and
yeah.
why would people want to get
yeah,
the room there?
Who would go to Bugahaw, right?
Like, I'm going to go to Omaha for 4 days and use his room. I was like, so
Cancun was all full.
Cancun was full.
Hawaii.
Something was going
Hawaii
on.
Hawaii closed their doors.
I'm thinking to myself, it's not ski season. Like, I don't know.
Right, because Omaha's famous for their good skiing.
Well, I didn't know. I was like, maybe they have snow there. It's Nebraska.
Right. Anyhow, so I want to talk before Johnny comes on the radio this morning a little bit about, you know, sometimes we share deals that we do and things like that. And I actually contracted one last night, okay. Had an appointment at 5. And it's interesting because we contracted a house in Houston, Texas for $7,500.
Okay.
Yeah. And now I'm not going to tell you that
somebody's living in this house.
Someone is living in the house. Now I'm not saying that they should be living in the house, but it does have electricity. It does have water service. Someone is living in the house, and we contracted. Now, here's the interesting thing. I was nervous at $7,500.
Really,
I felt a little more comfortable at $5,000, but I was kind of nervous at $7,500 because I mean I'm just, you know, all fixed up. I mean, what do you do when a house all fixed up is worth maybe $100? And it needs $70,000 in work. I mean, it's just, if you're going to do it, you know, the right way.
Yeah.
And but I'm not saying it has to be done the right way. I'm not saying any of the but when here's what I find is interesting. I realize that I'll be able to sell the house for more than $7,500. For I mean, I'll make more than $5,000, which we never do $5,000 assignment fees or anything like that.
Yeah.
But
not on purpose.
Not on purpose.
Every
right.
now and then it'll happen.
Not intentionally, right?
It's definitely not a part of the game.
We've normally made a mistake.
That's exactly when that happens.
It's not business
because
by design.
We would never sign up for $5,000. We would not do the deal. It just
right.
it's a.
But the thing that I wanted to touch on here is that how many people, number one, would be willing to make an offer that low, right? And then number two would be able to have the experience and the knowledge to back it up, because you know, truth be told, the seller was expecting like $25,000.
Oh wow!
They weren't expecting a ton, and they said they'd be willing to take even 15. And I know for a lot of people, from a negotiating standpoint, they would have caved and given in on the 15, and probably would have lost money. And what I recognize is that I didn't feel comfortable at all. I mean, I'd rather pass on the deal than contract it at 15.
Yeah.
But I know a lot of people would rather contract it at 15 than
pass on the deal.
Yeah, because
they got to have a deal.
Right. And so one of the things that I recognize is that I had the ability to empathize with the seller and to be able to say, hey, look, I know, and I like the seller a lot. I mean,
yeah.
And one of the things I said is like, hey, if I could offer $25,000 on this deal, I would
do it in a heartbeat.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Why would I not? I mean, that would make it so much easier, right? Just boom, boom. And I said, I'd love to get 15. In fact, you know, really, if I could, I'd love to offer you $1 million, right?
Yeah.
I mean, but
if we could both win with me giving you $1 million,
yeah, right.
Why wouldn't we do that?
Right, of course, right. Unfortunately, you know, and that's when you say, but you and I both know it's not worth $1 million. And then the other thing is just structurally, there were so many issues structurally. Like I've seen some houses before that have had termite damage.
Yeah.
This one, I've seen pictures like Jeff, you remember the house that Jeff with Fast Track posted one time?
Yes.
That's probably the worst that I've ever seen where you could actually see the beams that were ahead. This is probably the worst house that I've seen from a termite damage standpoint where walls are actually bowing.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, where like in the kitchen countertop, the wall has bowed away so much that the countertops are
leaning down
towards the wall.
Okay, so don't spill your drink.
Yeah, it's like it. I mean, so you figure that they don't have a kitchen in there. They don't. I mean, it's just. I don't know how somebody there isn't a hole in the ceiling in the roof that has created a huge hole in the ceiling. So you got an uncovered skylight in there.
Oh man.
Yeah, just it's a. I mean, it's a piece. It's a piece of to behold.
Okay.
It's a piece of work. I should
piece
say
to
that.
Behold.
A piece to behold. And, however. You know, I wonder how many investors would just not, like, give up, get so overwhelmed with all that's going on and not be able to quantify, because at some point, you've got to be able to say, okay, this is what it's worth in the condition that it's in. This is what and what I find for myself is the more uncomfortable I get with my number, the more I build in safety and comfort with the amount that I offer.
Yeah.
And I even said, hey, look, I feel a lot more comfortable at 5,000 than I do at 75. And I mean, I don't feel real nervous at 7,500. But and when I look at the neighborhood, it's amazing what some people have done with these houses in terms of just making them incredible. But it's in an area that it's not turning. I mean, it's not like in the Heights or something like that where you can say, oh, well, tear the house down and the lot's worth $300,000.
Yeah.
Even lots in the Heights aren't worth that anymore.
Of course.
But it's amazing how you've got to have knowledge of the local market and to be able to know, hey, what's going on in Sagemont? What's going on in Pearland? What's going on in Tomball? What's, you know, in each of these
I think that's key. I see so many people when they get started in this business, they don't take the time. They spend more time trying to learn the process than they do trying to learn the market.
Right.
And then they go in and, one, they either give the first number that was asked for because they don't know.
Sure, right.
Or, two, they walk away and say, let me run my numbers and I'll get back to you.
Right.
And you should know that before you get there.
Yeah, absolutely.
You should have an idea of what that market looks like and what you can pay for that house before you get there. Obviously, you can't see the repairs before you get there and that sort of thing, but you can do that math in your head once you get the repair number, right?
Absolutely.
And it's, I mean, how many deals are lost because people aren't prepared?
Absolutely.
It's huge.
Well, we were prepared because we not only made the offer on the spot, but we brought an agreement with us.
Absolutely.
And so she was willing to sign right then. And so we got it signed, and title will open up tomorrow today. I mean, and then we'll probably close on it next week.
Okay.
If we can get all the title stuff
cleared up,
and it's not that big of a deal from a title standpoint. And we should be able to close on this in about 2 weeks.
Awesome.
And then be able to put it back out on the market and take a look at, you know, all the exits. There's what we'll end up doing is really on Friday we'll talk about all of the different exit strategy possibilities, right? So that's the way we roll. So I know I've got less than a minute left, and so Rick, I'm just going to ask you: is Mr. Johnny Hayes on the line yet?
He just called in.
Cool, excellent. So we'll have Mr. Johnny Hayes, aka Mr. Johnny Cash, calling in, and we'll be talking about lending in the second segment.
Money, money, money.
Money, money, money. Money.
We'll be right back.
Hello, real estate investors. Do you need a lender that moves fast at the speed of a jet to fund your investment properties? Jet Lending will help you purchase properties quickly with as little cash out of pocket as possible. Jet Lending also sets up a repair escrow fund to help you with repair costs. Jet Lending has originated over 2,000 loans in Texas, valued at over $250 million. Jet Lending will help you evaluate your deals for free and give you feedback on value, cost of repairs, and potential loan amount. Jet Lending is your fast and friendly hard money source for first-time investors and seasoned professionals. Call 281-872-7800 or email us at info@jetlending.com. Oh, and don't forget about our famous Third Wednesday Super Investor Networking Meeting. Lots of fun, lots of great real estate talk. We'll see you there.
Time is money in a real estate deal. If your insurance company is slow or non-responsive, you could lose a deal like that. You need a quick turnaround on quotes, binders, and the agency for that is Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. The team at Benchmark understands the investor mindset. They know what you need and when you need it. It's there for you. Call Houston's leading real estate risk management experts, Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas, 281-569-4353.
Bought a house for seven, wholesaled May 13.
569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly general contractor for your investment property? Then call Fast Track Remodeling at 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Fast Track Remodeling specializes in turnkey remodeling of single-family investment properties. Whether it's a flip rehab or a rental rehab, we manage every aspect of a rehab from start to finish with a highly efficient, standardized process.
Good morning,
Jay. Over the last 6 years, Fast Track has completed over 700 projects, which has helped us to create our three keys to success. Use a detailed scope of work so that everything gets done, train and maintain quality crews so it gets done right, and complete the work in a proper order so it gets done fast.
No more managing it yourself. No more doing the work yourself. Fast Track Remodeling really does manage it all.
So give us a call today at 832-742-9992. Again, that's 832-742-9992. Or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
This is Business 1110.
Mic's on.
Hey, welcome back. Welcome back. Right Path Real Estate Radio. Oh, you know what I need to do?
I
need to put up Jet Lending. Hey, Mr. Johnny Hayes, Jet Lending. How are you doing, my friend?
Hey, Tom, how's it going?
Great. So are you in Texas or are you in Omaha?
I'm in Texas, but I will be in Omaha come Saturday morning.
Saturday morning, going to Bugahaw.
Yep. I fly out Saturday morning. I'll be up there about noon to watch a little college baseball.
Yeah.
Pulling my Mississippi State Bulldogs to their first national championship.
Yeah, right. Go Dogs, right?
Hell State, baby.
I understand. So I've been seeing a few posts on Facebook that you guys have got some summer specials. Let's talk about that.
Oh, that's my main topic today. I wanted to get with you. You know, we do a promotion every year to give back to our clients for all the, you know, loyalty and, you know, doing business with us. So this year it's our Jet Summer Heat promotion. We're out there for all our guys that want to buy, fix, and sell, and buy, fix, and hold, as well as transactional funding, you know, that we can help them with. So what we wanted to do is, starting last night and running through the end of July, anybody that originates a new loan with us, we've got special rates for the guys that are buying and holding. Anybody that has, you know, because if you're going to buy and hold, you got to have at least a certain credit score.
Correct.
And all we need is at least a 650 credit score. And if you're looking at something to buy and hold, our rates are as low as 8.5% if you've got at least 10% skin in the game with 2.5 points. If you buy it low enough where you don't have to put any money out of pocket, we're at a 8.9% with 3 points on our deal on a 6-month loan. And then for those that don't quite have as good a credit score, which we're not a credit-based lender, we're an asset-based lender. If you're buying, fixing, and flipping, if you're anywhere between a 620 to that 650, we can still get you a 9.9% rate with 3.5 points. And then for any of those under a 620 down to a 550, we'll even lower the rate to 11.9, where you're paying anywhere between 3 to 4 points for a buy, fix, and sell. And for those that have past credit history or no scores, we'll still give them a discount for those guys just looking once we get their file.
Yeah, got it. Wow, so you're saying that if I want to do buy and hold and I'm looking for 6 months, something like that, a 650 credit score, I can get as low as 8.5 points if I'm willing to put down just as little as 10%. But I can go
8.5% interest only rate.
Yeah, that's amazing.
And then you'd be paying 2.5 points on your deal.
That's fantastic.
That's still subject to underwriting approval.
Yeah, of course, right.
You know, I mean, we're not going to underwrite a house that's about to fall in and needs to be a teardown.
Right,
you know, I mean, let's use common sense lending here.
Yeah,
you know,
absolutely.
We get some crazy things that come over here, but we're going to analyze the deal for you at no cost, make sure you're getting in a good deal, that you can make money. And that's why you use people like Jet Lending, because we're here to help you succeed, to make sure you make money on your deals so you'll do more deals with
absolutely. Well, and I know you're always good for a great story. So what's one of the craziest deals you've ever been presented?
Oh, gosh. Well, you know, what I'd say the craziest ones are the big white elephants.
Yeah.
You know,
mm-hmm.
You know, if you want to be in this business and you got some reserves, go out there and buy houses that are worth $150,000 to $250,000 and maybe $300,000.
Right.
I get more investors that'll call me up. I've got the deal of the century.
Yeah.
I got a house over here in Memorial that's worth $2.5 million.
Right.
There's nothing wrong with it.
Right.
Oh,
yeah.
It doesn't need any work.
Right.
And I can buy this thing for $500,000.
Yeah.
And then I can sell it for $2.5 million.
Yeah, right.
And it's been on the market for the last 180 days at $600,000.
Right.
And they made a $500,000 offer, and they got
accepted. Of course. Yeah. And there's no red flags there, right?
No, none whatsoever. But here's the good thing. They have no money in the bank.
Yeah.
And I'm asking them, well, then how are you going to handle the loan? Oh, well, you just loan me all the money. And I'm said, okay, well, what happens when something goes wrong? Oh, you just take care of it. And, you know, people don't understand. A lender's here to help you be successful, but the investor assumes a lot of the risk.
Yes.
The lender assumes they're part of the risk, and that's what we underwrite for. We underwrite to make sure you're in a good deal. We'll loan you the money, but you know it's the investor's deal, and you know you got to learn from these things, and you got to have a little money to keep you out of trouble.
Right.
You know.
Well, in fact, you know,
that's why we try not to put them in deals that they can't handle. Now, if they bought a deal that was a heck of a deal and they had no money, I'd be happy to try to buy the house from them and let them put a good amount of money in their pocket so they can build their reserves and then maybe do a flip on their next one.
Absolutely. You know? Well, and what you find is what are the red flags? I mean, what makes them think that deal's worth $2.5 million if it didn't sell on MLS at 600, right? I mean, where they especially if it doesn't need much work, or the ones that I see a lot of times is people don't understand that you know when you're down to the studs on a house that you're pretty much looking at $60 a foot to bring it back, right? And because if it's now it's different if it's just down to the studs because of flooding, but I mean if people have rehabbed or it was new construction and it was just to the stud phase, oftentimes we found it's about $60 a foot. Well, you'll see somebody says, oh, it's a 4,500 square foot house and it's $100,000 of rehab. And I'm like, okay, so $60 a foot times 4,500 feet. That's a little bit more than $100,000. Yeah,
turn that up.
Right, and people go, but $100,000, you can do so much with $100,000. Yeah, I can do a lot for $100,000, but I can't bring that 4,500 square foot house up to retail. And I think people get lost in not recognizing that what you do for $20 a foot is the same from house to house. But if it's a 2,500 square foot house, that's $50,000 for rehab, and if it's a 4,000 square foot house, that's $80,000 of rehab. So it's the square footage of the house makes a huge bit of a difference when you're calculating what your repair costs are.
Yeah, and what you also run into some of the investors, well, I don't need to spend $80,000. I'm going to do the work myself.
Oh, gosh.
And I can get it done for maybe $30,000.
Sure.
And I'm like, would you have any experience in remodeling houses?
Right.
Oh, no, but, you know, I've painted my house before, but I can do this.
Yeah, right.
And it just, you know, things don't make sense.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
I'm going to watch some YouTube videos. We're going to get it done.
I'm going to get this figured out. I'm going to 10X it. I'm going to learn how to – I'm going to watch the YouTube videos on how to lay tile. I'll do the backsplash.
It's going to be great.
Yeah, exactly. I'll do the shower pan.
You know, and I tell people, hey, and I tell people, you know, when we help you analyze these deals, if I'm going to loan you off of future ARV mm-hmm. of what the house should sell for, completely updated, mm-hmm. then you got to update it. You can't cut back on your repairs because then you're not going to get your ARV
right.
when you go to try to sell it, or even when you go to try to hold it as a rental because there's a separate appraisal there.
Right.
But guess what? We do have a new program that we worked out with Fast Track Remodeling. You know, it's a turnkey. You come borrow the money from us, and if you're borrowing the money from Fast Track, we'll advance them the money so you don't even have to have out-of-pocket because we know they do great work. They update the property to the ARV, and now it's a smooth transaction that you get in there where if you had to go hire your contractors and manage them and do it, it may take you 3, 4, 5 months to get it, where they get in there in 6 weeks.
Yeah.
You have less holding time. You sell it quicker. You refi quicker. And it's a better opportunity, even though you may have to pay a little premium for somebody to manage it and do it everything for you, and you come out better, and you learn how it should be done properly.
Well, you pay for their expertise, you pay for their management, you pay for the fact that they have real insurance.
Yeah,
I mean that they run it like a real business.
And I feel like that's a game changer
right,
for so many
right,
people because, I mean, over the years I've seen so many people that have not been able to do a deal just because they didn't have the money to stay ahead of the draw.
Right.
This completely eliminates that. You have your reserves for the loan, but a lot of times people don't have both, the reserves and the money to stay ahead of the draw. I mean, working with Jet Lending and Fast Track, that's going to open up so many more deals for so many more people.
And I was with a good friend of mine. We have a meeting every Wednesday talking about business and things like that. And he said, hey, come over, take a look at this property with me. And so we did. And it's east of 59, north of 610. Excuse me, north of I-10, but south of 610. And it's an area that's in transition, and sure enough, some contractor over there, I mean, they paid him to do a lot of stuff, and he did about half of it, and he's been outed on Facebook that somebody named Nacho or something, I've heard
Ignacio.
Of him.
Oh, gosh, stay away from Nacho.
Yeah, and so, I mean, so they hired Nacho, And which, you know, fill in the blank. I mean, how many names could you throw out there that are like that? I mean, he's just now. And the trouble is, yep. is apparently Nacho built a pretty good reputation for a while, and he was doing a good job, and then he was growing his business and growing his business. But, you know, it takes money to grow your business because yep. it's cash flow and all that, right? And, you know, either Ace, life happened or, you know, whatever. I mean, I don't know his personal story, but it's the same song, different verse. Yep. Just fill in the blank with who the artist is, so to speak, right? And how many times have you heard that story before, Johnny?
Many times. Yeah, right. You know, and I got one going on right now that their contractors run off. They've given them too much money. Wow. I'm trying to send one of our guys over or tell them to call Fast Track to come in and look at it and just, hey, what's happened in the past, you got to put it behind you. If you dwell on the negative,
yeah.
it's going to affect your future. You know, okay, let's get in. Let's get out of this. We may not make that 20% we tried to. Right. But if we can get in and stop the bleeding and get it done correctly, and let's just say we break even on this one, we'll make our money on the next one, and the lesson that we learn will be a lesson that'll teach us the rest of our life. We don't need to do it that way, and then we become successful.
Yeah, 2 minutes. This is when you really have to ask, is a cheaper contractor really cheaper?
Yeah. yeah. 9 times out of 10, they aren't.
Yeah. And so, and there's a reason why they're cheaper is oftentimes they're good at what they do in terms of being a, they're good at laying tile. They're good at sheetrock. They might be good at painting. Maybe they're good at siding or putting in windows. They're not necessarily good at business, and you have to be good at both sides of those because, yes. you know, you have to stay in business. You know this, Johnny, the short term, it takes cash flow. Long term, it takes profit.
Yeah.
And a lot of these guys don't know how to calculate their profit correctly. Yeah. They don't know the difference between markup and margin. And I mean, they didn't learn those things. You know, their dad taught them how to do light plumbing or light electrical, and good for them. I mean, but that doesn't make them necessarily good business people. Correct. And you see it on Facebook.
A great business owner. Yeah. I agree with you 100%.
So Johnny, we got an event coming up with you guys next Wednesday, right?
Yeah, let's talk about that.
I heard there's going to be tacos.
Yeah,
there.
1 minute.
You know. Hey, that third Wednesday of every month, if y'all don't have that on your calendar, I mean, we have great speakers. We have great topics. We give away this information for free. We're here to make the investors in Houston successful. It doesn't cost you anything to come. If you don't like it, then don't come back. But I promise you, if you'll come and invite your friends and just see what happens, it's a great atmosphere. It's a great networking deal. We introduce you to people in this business that can help make you successful. We have over 30-something sponsors there that are successful in the business, that help people make money in this deal. And hey, Republic Country Club on the South Side, come down third Wednesday. If you haven't got on our mailing list, email us at info@jetlending.com. We'll get you on our mailing list to make sure you're invited so you can RSVP.
All right, Mr. Johnny Cash,
we'll see you there.
Mr. Johnny Hayes, thanks for being on the show. It's jetlending.com, 281-872-7800 or info@jetlending.com. Hey, have a safe trip this weekend.
Thank you, guys.
All right,
take
see
care.
You. God bless. Bye-bye.
Hello, real estate investors. Do you need a lender that moves fast at the speed of a jet to fund your investment properties? Jet Lending will help
good morning,
you
Marty. Good morning, Mike.
Quickly with as little cash out of pocket as possible. Jet Lending also sets up a repair escrow fund to help you with repair costs. Jet Lending has originated over 2,000 loans in Texas valued at over $250 million. Jet Lending will help you evaluate your deals for free and give you feedback on value, cost of repairs, and potential loan amount. Jet Lending is your fast and friendly hard money source for first-time investors and seasoned professionals. Call 281-872-7800 or email us at info@jetlending.com. Oh, and don't forget about our famous Third Wednesday Super Investor Networking Meeting. Lots of fun, lots of great real estate talk. We'll see you there.
Time is money in a real estate deal. If your insurance company is slow or non-responsive, you could lose a deal like that. You need a quick turnaround on quotes or binders? The agency for that is Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. The team at Benchmark understands the investor mindset. They know what you need and when you need it. We're here for you. Are you a rehabber, wholesaler, buy and hold, or flipper? Bundling your properties on a single policy will help save time and money. Benchmark has been in business for over 10 years, and we insure over 30,000 properties. contact Benchmark about our exclusive investor package. Call us and let us show you what we can do for you at 281-569-4353. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com. That's benchmarkbroker.com. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly general contractor for your investment property? Then call Fast Track Remodeling at 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Fast Track Remodeling specializes in turnkey remodeling of single-family investment properties. Whether it's a flip rehab or a rental rehab, we manage every aspect of a rehab from start to finish with a highly efficient, standardized process.
Over the last 6 years, Fast Track has completed over 700 projects, which has helped us to create our three keys to success. Use a detailed scope of work so that everything gets done, train and maintain quality crews so it gets done right, and complete the work in a proper order so it gets done fast.
No more managing it yourself, no more doing the work yourself. Fast Track Remodeling really does manage it all.
So give us a call today at 832-742-9992. Again, that's 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
This is Business 1110.
Mic's on.
Welcome back. Welcome back. Right Path Real Estate Radio, 713-785-1817. I just had a wonderful call with Johnny Hayes from Jet Lending, talking about their new products. If you did not catch the information on their next event, that is going to be Wednesday night at the Republic Country Club down in Stafford. You can find out about that at jetlending.com, or you can shoot me an email, support@rightpathrealestate.com. We'll get you the info you need. And we'll be there, so please come by and talk to us as well. Tom will be presenting from stage, give you a little more information about what we've got going on. So it's a great event. I'd say it's probably the largest of its kind in the country. It's a really awesome event. So
I've spoken at a lot of events. You know, it's I tell you, a typical large event across the country is if an event can ever get to 200 people,
yeah,
then that's a pretty large event.
Yeah,
and but this one is probably 3.5 to 5 times that, depending on the month.
Yeah,
I mean it
anywhere from 750 to 1,000, 1,100 people sometimes,
which is just unheard of. Because I remember I started in the group in the early days of Fast Track, and when there were probably 30 people.
That's amazing.
That was going and saw it, you know, when it just used to meet at SRO over on the. On the 290 and 610, yeah, the Northwest Mall right there, and it'd meet you know, SRO was a pretty big bar, but they had this like meeting room back in the back right corner, and there were literally only about 30 of us, and wow. and then when it grew from that, we went to Houston Texans Bar and Grill,
yeah,
and that's really when it started growing in a big way. But now that it's at the Republic Country Club. And it's amazing how big it's getting.
Yeah,
and
I mean, what a great venue.
It is.
Yeah.
And here's what's interesting is that it's an opportunity for you to go and network. And here's the key with networking is that are you there to bring value to other people? So, like, what's your level of value? Or are you there to learn? And because both of those are – and then are you looking to expand your group of people that are in your relationship base,
yeah,
right? And what I mean by that is, you know, as we're going through life, we have an opportunity to build relationships with people. That means you getting to know them and them getting to know you, and hopefully you're wanting to bring value to their life, and they'll reciprocate that and bring value in your life, and then you grow your business that way.
Yeah.
And what's amazing is that you'll have a lot of people there. They're just getting started. Nothing wrong with that. I mean, everybody has to start somewhere. I mean, no one should be afraid to get started. But that's where you see a lot of people get defeated right, yeah, off the bat, is they're never willing to get started. Imagine if this group, I mean, I know people that have started other groups, for example, and they go, oh my gosh, well, you know, I don't have 1,000 people yet. Well, neither did they for the first four, yeah, or 5 years, right? Yeah. And it's like if you want to start out and have 1,000 people before you get started, you'll never start, right?
Yeah.
And so that's the way it is in many things in life. And so if you're flipping houses, if you're doing buy and hold, if you're doing wholesale, go to an event like that. Talk to different people. You'll get a lot of different opinions. You really will.
For sure.
And then so, you know, one of the things that I always do is like, you know, and I have a methodology to the way, I mean, I have a system and a process for a lot of things that I do in my life. And one of those things that I have a system and process for is networking an event.
Yeah.
And you've seen it at work before. We've gone to networking events before, and you and I don't hang out at a networking event. No. We typically go to different directions. We engage because I not saying that I know everything you know and or vice versa, but.
We've shared quite a bit of it.
Right. But, you know, when I go to a networking event, I'm not there to camp out with just one person.
Yeah.
It's like if there's 50 people there, I want to meet at least 90% of them. If there's 1,000 people, I don't want to meet everybody. Yeah. It's not physically possible because then I'm too focused on the goal of getting through everybody that I'm not focusing exactly. on the people that are in front of me. But what I'm doing is filtering. I really am. It's like, hey, can I help you or can you help me? Are our goals mutually aligned?
And having seen you in action, one of the amazing things that I've noticed that you do is you're not. Your goal isn't to get to the next person,
right?
No, it's
not.
You'll run a conversation as long as the interaction is still beneficial to both.
Correct.
And the learning process is still happening.
Right.
But I've through different conversations, I've seen that take place very quickly.
Yes.
And I've seen you wrap it up very quickly because that part is done.
Right.
And then I've seen the ones that draw out longer that you stick and stay for those to come to fruition. So you definitely have a skill set when it comes to networking.
Well, it's something that I've worked on, and no one's born knowing how to network. It's a learned skill.
No,
no one's born a brain surgeon. No one's, okay. Yeah. And so just recognize that that's a skill set that you can learn. And I've recognized early on is the root word of networking is work.
Yes.
And so I'm trying to build my network. And what I'm looking for when I'm building my network, I'm looking for people with high character and integrity, people that are tens at what they do, or people that are on their way to being a 10 at what they do.
Yeah.
And so then I'm looking for, you know, where are the gaps in what, you know, they're looking for. And sometimes it's just not a fit from the get-go. You know, like, for example, if I I'm not really looking for a roofer right now. So if I meet somebody, oh, what do you do for a living? Oh, I'm a roofer. Well, I may ask, okay, well, what do you charge per square for roofs? Well, $250 a square. Well, right now I'm paying $175 a square. So I'm not really looking. Now, I might take their card, but I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time saying, oh, well, what brand of shingles do you use? And how long have you been in roofing and all those kind of things?
Because it doesn't matter.
It doesn't really matter at that point. So I'm on to the next person. Now, if somebody says, well, I charge $175, I might be looking for a backup because, you know, in life, like I had a, you know, I'm very loyal to the trades that I use and because they're also loyal to me because I build a relationship with those folks. I'm not always looking for the lowest price, but, you know, for example, like I had a tree trimmer and landscaping guy. But he had a life event happen.
Yeah.
I mean, he got in a dangerous situation, and he ended up getting shot.
Yeah.
And so you never know. I mean, so imagine if he was the only guy in my Rolodex for that.
Absolutely.
So you got to always have to have a backup.
Well, not only that, but this business is a lot about scheduling.
Right, it is.
Right? And a roofer
say, hey,
can only have so many jobs
right.
that he's in the middle of.
Sure.
And, like, for example, we need a roof done on Monday.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Right?
Right.
And we made that call yesterday,
right.
which is, what, 5 days out?
Right.
So, hey, I need a roof on Monday. Monday.
Sure, right.
Like, what if that guy's not available till Thursday? That 4 days is 4 days in this business. So
yeah.
a lot of times you want to have another person that you can reach out to that's not that, but you're calling your relationship guy first, right?
Right. right.
So I think, you know, it's definitely important to always have a backup.
And then the other thing that I do is, there's a lot of times I'm either going in to add value to other people in a networking event because sometimes I'm not really looking for a specific, you know, need in networking, but sometimes I'm looking to add value to other people. So oftentimes I'll meet somebody, hey, what do you do for a living? Oh, I'm a real estate investor. Oh, great. What kind of real estate investing?
Yeah.
Oh, I do all kinds. Great. I mean, residential, commercial, multifamily, single family, you do everything. I'm like, oh, okay, well, that now we got a little bit of a problem,
yeah.
right? Because now we talked yesterday about generalists versus specialists.
Yeah.
And we recognize that specialists typically make more money than generalists. And then I'll typically say, oh, well, that's how long have you been doing that? Oh, I've been doing it for 3 years. Great. I mean, how many deals have you done? Well, I'm still looking to find my first deal. Oh, okay. Well, then nice to meet you. My name's Tom. I'm a neurosurgeon.
Neurosurgeon.
And I go, oh, okay. Well, what are you doing here? Well, You know, didn't have anything else to do. I don't have any surgeries till tomorrow. In fact, I haven't done a surgery yet.
I haven't done a surgery yet.
Actually, haven't done one yet.
Still looking for my first one. Right. But I heard they had tacos. I'm here.
I heard they had tacos, yeah. So who doesn't like tacos?
So you touched on a key point there that I'd like to expand upon is you're not always necessarily looking for a certain thing at a networking event, mm-hmm. but you are at times you're coming across people that you can provide value to.
Right.
I think so many times we get in the mindset of what we need for to solve our next problem.
Yeah.
We forget that our relationship is two ways.
Yeah.
So you're not walking around a networking event looking for a one-sided relationship.
No.
And a lot of people, they approach it that way.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm looking for the people that can do something for me.
Yeah.
And you're going to have a hard time finding those people if they can't see that you can do something for them as well.
Right.
Right? So you've got to portray that value. You've got to be able be willing to give that value back and show people that you are.
Well, you know, you find that a lot when investors are getting started, or even if they've been in it for a while. And I've seen it a ton when they see life as a zero sum game. And what I mean by that is, if there's $100 to be had out of a deal, that if I can negotiate $60 out of it and you have $40 out of it, then that's, you know, there's only $100. So the more I win, the more you lose. This is a win-lose negotiation, right? Now, sometimes we are in situations where we are negotiating like that. And typically those involve like one transaction type of situations. Like, you know, I say if you're dealing with a seller on a house, I mean, typically, you know, I'm going to negotiate to get the best deal
every
I can.
Dollar.
Every single dollar. Yes. But I'm also not looking to build a relationship long term with that
Correct.
Person. I'm looking to solve their problem, and then I'm moving on to the next deal, right? That's different than working with a landscaper, for example, or a general contractor, or a roofer, or whatever, where I'm going to need that consistently, a locksmith, over and over and over again. I don't necessarily want that. I mean, I'm not going to. I've told this story before, but it's been a while, so I might share it again, that there was a situation where I called up a landscaper and I said, hey, I want you to go out and take a look at this house. And it's a house we were about ready to just slaughter the profit margin on this deal. I mean, we had bought it for, I want to say, $225,000, $227,000, something like that. We had put like 70 in it, so we're all in for $300,000. We're about ready to put it on the market for like $425,000.
2 minutes.
We actually sold it at $417,000, $418,000, right in there. Yeah. I mean, we murdered it. So this guy calls, you know, I call him, hey, can you go out and take a look at the I need some landscaping done, and I really need some nice curb appeal. And he said, yeah, I'll go out and take a look. And, you know, he called me back and he says, I think I can do everything you need for about $800. And he goes, what do you think? And I said, I think it's too low. And he goes, what do you mean? I go, well, I think it should cost more than that. And number one, what kind of relationship does that build with that trade? And you know, he came back and he goes, well, okay, well, how about $1 million? And I said, well, I think you've overshot the other direction. Yeah. I mean, that's a little bit too high. And he goes, well, okay, well, how about $1,500? And I go, yeah, let's. And so do you think he's going to do the same work and effort for the $800 that he would for $1,500?
Now,
I mean, maybe, but so what? Here's the bigger question is, have I built a relationship with this guy?
You have, and I can tell you, like, any person in that kind of
one
situation,
minute.
Yeah.
They're going to put so much more of their heart into
what
they're doing.
Right.
You know, we had a locksmith that we called out on a property the other day, and I had to stay back because you had an appointment.
Right.
And there were some pieces missing on the door that caused him to do some extra work, and
he
was worried about approaching me with the extra cost and things like that. I was like, hey, I trust you.
Yeah, right.
You're the professional. You do what you need to do.
Right.
We'll pay what we need to pay.
Right.
And he was kind of like, well, that was easy.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And, you know, we've used him 3 or 4 times since then. I called him yesterday or the day before, and I was like, hey, I can't meet you at this property, but I need you to go, like, and he was there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Right.
It's those little things. You say you spend a little extra money, sure.
Yeah.
But to say that you don't get it back later would be a lie, because it always comes back around.
Well, imagine if I'm paying $50 more for a locksmith, but I don't have to go meet him out there, and I can just pick up the phone and trust. I'd rather pay that extra money and know that he's going to be there when he says he's going to be. Music says I'm out of time. We'll continue this on the other side of the break. You're listening to Right Path to Real Estate Radio. We'll be right back. It's Speaking of that,
time is money in a real estate deal.
I know that we got a one call from someone that said they were having trouble getting in. Was that?
You could lose a deal.
No, I need to reach out to him today.
You need a quick turnaround on quotes or binders. The agency for that is Benchmark Insurance.
Doesn't unlock the lock.
The team at Benchmark understands the investment.
I wonder if he only keyed the top one, not planning on that bottom one.
Are you a rehab?
No, I think he keyed it. Something's
buy and hold or flipper. Properties like on a single policy will help save time and money.
Okay.
Benchmark has been in business for over 10 years, and we insure over 30,000 properties. Contact Benchmark about our exclusive investor package. Call us and let us show you what we can do for you at 281-569-4353. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com. That's benchmarkbroker.com. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
Hello, real estate investors. Do you need a lender that moves fast at the speed of a jet to fund your investment properties? Jet Lending will help you purchase properties quickly with as little cash out of pocket as possible.
Hey, good morning, Eric.
Jet Lending also sets up a repair escrow fund to help you with repair costs. Jet Lending has originated over 2,000 loans in Texas, valued at over $250 million. Jet Lending will help you evaluate your deals for free and give you feedback on value, cost of repairs, and potential loan amount. Jet Lending is your fast and friendly hard money source for first-time investors and seasoned professionals. Call 281-872-7800 or email us at info@jetlending.com. Oh, and don't forget about our famous Third Wednesday Super Investor Networking Meeting. Lots of fun, lots of great real estate talk. We'll see you there.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly general contractor for your investment property? Then call Fast Track Remodeling at 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Fast Track Remodeling specializes in turnkey remodeling of single-family investment properties. Whether it's a flip rehab or a rental rehab, we manage every aspect of a rehab from start to finish with a highly efficient, standardized process.
Over the last six years, Fast Track has completed over 700 projects, which has helped us to create our three keys to success. Use a detailed scope of work so that everything gets done.
One time,
train and maintain quality crews so it gets done right, and complete the work in a proper order so it gets done fast.
We're going to a movie.
No more managing it yourself. No more doing the work yourself.
One of my
Fast
kids
Track Remodeling really does manage it all.
So give us a call today. 832-742-9992. Again, that's 832-742-9992. Or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Awesome.
This is Business 1110.
Mic's on.
Yeah, Rick stepped up his game on the bumper music. That's for sure. Way to go, Rick. Rick's our producer on the show. Just want to give him a shout out and say thanks so much. You're doing a great job. So
thank you.
So welcome back, Right Path Real Estate Radio. My name is Tom Perry. I'm the host of the show. I'm joined live in the studio with Mr. Daniel G. And so we were talking on the other side of the break about building relationships, and we got off on that topic because of the networking event that's coming up.
Yeah.
And so are you looking to build relationships with people? I'll never forget, maybe it was a year ago, something like that, I was at a different networking event, and we were actually one of the sponsors. So I was sitting out in front of the table, meeting people as people were walking by, and people were asking questions, things like that. And we were talking about what we teach people how to do and how we correct some broken thinking, things like that. And this guy was probably early 70s, something like that. And he says, look, I've got seven rentals, and I'm looking to get out of the rental game. And I'm like, why would you – I mean, if I'm 70 years old, I mean, the only thing better than seven rental properties is eight. The only thing better than eight is nine,
Absolutely.
And he wanted to get out, and I'm like, there's no better investment right now. And he goes, well, I'm having a tough time, finding general contractors, good general contractors. And I'm like, well, are you a good customer for a good general contractor? And he goes, well, what do you mean? And I go, well, I mean, I used to own a good general contracting business. And I could tell the difference between a good general contracting customer and a bad general contracting customer. And so, we very quickly were in feel blessed enough to say that we were able to fire our bad general contracting customers, right? And so in that scenario, I said, are you the kind of guy that if I owned a good general contracting business that I would want to do business with you? He goes, well, I don't know. And I go, are you the kind of guy that's going to try and beat me up on price? Are you the kind of guy that's, you know, if I say, hey, it's $22,412 to do this, oh, my budget's only $19,000. I mean, do you realize how small the margin is for most general contractors because it is a competitive marketplace, all that? Not like a guy's going to go in and do a $40,000 bid on $25,000 of work. The marketplace just doesn't allow it. Maybe, you, I mean, not for the good ones because they're so – now, granted, are there some guys that will take advantage of a situation? Yes, but not the ones that are looking to build long-term relationships. Correct. Like that, right? So he goes, you know, I never really thought about it like that. He goes, no, I'm probably the guy that's going to beat you up on price. And I go, are you also the guy that's going to, you know, hound me, you know, want me to start it yesterday? Not, I mean, are you the kind of guy that plans in advance? Like, you know, I normally call in Fast Track saying, hey, I've got a closing coming up next Tuesday, you know, so can you go ahead and work me into your calendar? Or do you wait till you close it on Tuesday and then, you know, hey, you know, I've got this job. Can you come out, give me a bid and start tomorrow? I mean, it's like, I mean, nobody wants to do business that way, you know? I mean, it's like, now... And
good contractors aren't sitting at home waiting on your call either.
We were supposed to have two closings today, and one of them got pushed to next week. So the moment that I knew, the very first call that I made was to Jeff yesterday and to say, hey, just to let you know, because again, it's about relationships, and I'm thinking about, you know, being a good client for him.
Yeah.
And granted, I mean, he's my brother and all that, but it's still, I want to treat that like a business.
Absolutely.
I don't want to take advantage just because he's a... In fact,
2 minutes.
He would want to, I mean, right? I want to look out for him. I want to look out for us, but it's like, are you treating your trades like that? So that's what you should be looking at as you're building your network. Are you looking to add value to the person that you're doing relationships with? And if not, then you've got a lot to learn about doing business.
Absolutely.
So you've been listening to Right Path Real Estate Radio. I know I've only got a minute or so left. What I want to tell you about is next week we've got quite a few events that are taking place. Tonight we've got for our base camp folks. So we've got Elijah from Fast Track
coming out for base camp. He's
right.
He's gonna be doing some talking to those folks.
And then next Tuesday we're gonna have a Wealth Through Real Estate webinar. Right. Yeah. And so that's going to be next Tuesday, and then on Wednesday we've got the Super Networking event at the I have to get used to it. It's the Republic Country Club. Right. Yeah. So that's over at West Airport. Going to be a fabulous event. But even more important than all of that, you may want to share about what we're doing Thursday.
So Thursday night we're doing our case study.
Yeah.
We didn't have one last month. We had so much going on. We actually skipped a month, but we try to do one a month. this month we're actually doing a deal you did, which was a fourplex that you bought with no money out of pocket, and you're going to tell everybody how you found the deal, how it came to you, and go over the numbers and how you bought it and what it's going to cash flow and all that. Again, you've heard me say several times that we will be cutting off
30 seconds.
We've probably gone farther past that than we should, but we're going to hang on for a little bit and do our best to squeeze
20 seconds
in. But register for that as soon as possible at rightpathrealestate.com. That's going to be next Thursday, June 20th, starting at 6:30. We hope that you can make it out.
10 seconds.
See you on the webinar next week. Tom and I will be back tomorrow morning. Enjoy the rest of your Thursday. I know we'll be busy, and we hope you will be too.
All right. Thanks so much. We love you guys. Bye-bye.
You've been listening to Right Path Real Estate Radio. Find Tom at rightpathrealestate.com. You can put the fear behind you and listen every day from 9 to 10 a.m. on Business 1110 KTEK.